School presents Storified.
Today's story is After 20 Years by renowned American author O.Henry. O.Henry was born in 1862 in North Carolina, United States of America. This was the time, if we recall, when United States of America was reeling in the Civil War between the Northern and Southern states to abolish slavery under the stewardship of President Abraham Lincoln. The real name of O'Henry was William Sidney Porter. Some of his famous short stories include The Gift of the Magi and Jimmy Valentine. Most of O'Henry's stories talk of everyday American life in a romantic, eccentric, and humorous way. After 20 Years is a story of two childhood friends who part ways but promise to meet after 20 years at the same place from where they had separated. It is about 10 o'clock in the night. The weather was chilly with gusts of cold wind blowing with a light drizzle. The streets were almost deserted. The anchor of the story, Shrestha Day. The narrator of the story, Silky Bob, and policeman in plain clothes, T.S. Chatterjee. Police officer alias Jimmy Wells, Sandeep Guhoroy.
A police officer was on his night rounds with a baton in his hand, tapping doors as he walked. A few cigar stores were open, but most of the business houses were closed. The sight of a man leaning on the doorway of a hardware store with an unlighted cigar in his mouth made the police officer, Jimmy Wells, slow down. The man, whose name was Bob, said, "It's all right, officer. I'm just waiting for a friend. It's an appointment made 20 years ago. Sounds a little funny to you, doesn't it, officer? Well, I'll explain. 20 years ago, there used to be a restaurant where the store stands today, Big Joe Brady's restaurant.
They tore it down 5 years ago."
Bob lit up his cigar, and in the light of the match, the police officer, Jimmy Wells, saw a pale, square-jawed face with keen eyes and a little white scar near his right eyebrow. He wore a large diamond as a scarf pin. 20 years ago tonight, I dined here with Jimmy Wells, my best chum. He's the finest chap in the world. He and I were raised here in New York. I was 18 and Jimmy was 20. The next morning, I was to leave for the West to make my fortune there. We agreed that night that we would meet here again, exactly 20 years from that day and time. No matter what our conditions might be, or from what distance we might have to come, we figured that in 20 years' time, each of us ought to have our destiny worked out and our fortunes made, whatever they're gonna be.
Sounds pretty interesting. Rather a long time between meets, though it seems to me. Haven't you heard from your friend since you left?
Well, yes. For a time, we wrote to each other. But after a year or two, we lost track. I was busy making my fortune. But I know Jimmy will meet me here if he's alive. For he's always was the truest chap who never failed to keep his word. I came 1,000 miles to stand in this door tonight, and it is worth it if Jimmy turns up. With this, Bob pulled out a beautiful watch set with small diamonds. 3 minutes to 10. It was exactly 10 o'clock when we parted here at the restaurant door.
Did pretty well out in the West, didn't you?
You bet. I hope Jimmy has done well too. Jimmy always wanted to be in New York and never bothered to venture out.
So long. I'll be on my way. Good luck. I hope your friend turns up sharp.
I'll give Jimmy 1/2 hour at least. If Jimmy is alive on Earth, he'll be here by that time. So long, officer. Twenty minutes later, a man in plain clothes arrives. The man says, "Is that you, Bob? Is it you, Jimmy Wells?" "Bless my heart, it's Bob, sure as fate. I was certain I'd find you here if you were still in existence. Well, 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 20 years is a long time. The old's gone, Bob. I wish it had lasted, so we could have had another dinner there. How has the West treated you, old man?"
"Bully. It has given me everything I asked it for. You've changed lots, Jimmy. I never thought you were so tall by 2 or 3 inches.
I grew a bit after he left.
Doing well in New York, Jim?"
"Moderately. I have a position in one of the city departments. Come on, Bob. Let's go to a place where we can talk of old times." They walked down the street and suddenly stopped in front of a drugstore where they could see each other's face in the neon light of the drugstore.
"You're not Jimmy Wells. 20 years is a long time, but not too long enough to change a man's face from a Roman to a pug."
20 years is long enough to make a good person bad. You're in fact under arrest for the last 10 minutes, Silky Bob. Chicago police is looking for you and wants to have a chat with you. But before we go, here's a note that I have to hand over to you. Read it and your head will be clear. It's from Jimmy Wells."
Bob reads the letter in which the real officer, Jimmy Wells, writes.
"I was at the appointed place on time. When you struck the match to light your cigar, I saw it was the face of the man wanted in Chicago. I could not arrest you myself, so I went around and got a plainclothes man to do the job. Jimmy."
You just heard O'Henry's short story, After 20 Years. Hope you enjoyed the story. Stay tuned for another exciting episode of Storyfied next week. Bye-bye.